Hi everyone. In the previous video, we learned how to do selection sort. In this video, we'll do bubble sort. What do you mean by a bubble sort? In a bubble sort, what we do is we compare two adjacent. We compare adjacent array elements. Adjacent array elements, and we exchange if they are out of order. So what we have concluded in selection sort is selection sort starts from the left side, that is from the 0th position, and in the bubble sort what happens is the first place which has sorted will be placed in the size minus 1 location. We'll just look at the example now. So in this example 25, 30, 10, 15, what we are doing is we compare adjacent elements, that is what this one and this adjacent array elements is what A of 0 and A of 1, and after this A of 1, A of 2, next A of 2, A of 3, next A of 3, A of 4. In that way we'll compare. So we'll check how to do in the first pass. 20 is greater than 5, true or false? Yes, it is true. So we interchange, we'll get 5, 20, 30, 10, 15. So first is finished. In that next iteration, 20 and 30 will check. 20 is greater than 30, true or false? False. So it will be in the same way. And next, now 20 is 30 is finished. Now 30, 10. 30 is greater than 10, true or false? True or false? True. Yes. 30 is greater than 10, true or false? Yes, it is true. So when it is true, this will be changed to 5, 20, 10, 30. These are interchange. And again 10, 30 and 15 we will check. 30 is greater than 15, true or false? Yes, it is true. So 15 and 30. So 30 finished. Do you have any other element? No. So this will complete your first pass. See, when a first pass is completed, what you recognize here, the bigger element. What are the bigger element you see? That is placed in the last element. Okay, last element size location. Sorry. So this is how you. Now, when we go for second pass, do we again need to do the sorting? No, there is no need of doing sorting. So we'll just ignore this. Ignoring means we have to do something in the logic. So we are ignoring. We only go with the four passes. So now again we'll start from first. 5 is greater than 2, true or false? That is true. So 2 will be interchanged and 5 will get here. Again we have to do these things. So 5 is greater than 10. 5 is greater than 10, false. Again, 10 is greater than 15, false. So you'll get in the second pass 2, 5, 10, 15, 30. Actually here we already done the sorting. But even though we go with all the other elements, like next we go with, again we'll go with 2, 5 and 5, 10, and next we go with 2 and 5. So in this way we do the bubble sort. Okay. So what is the technique actually? So in whenever we do the bubble sort, what is happening is we are only checking for n minus 1 here. Till n minus 1 we are doing, and j is less than n minus 1 minus I. Why we are writing n minus 1 minus I here is the last element in bubble sort, last element is sorted. So we don't want this. So who is going to tell about this last element means I. So for example, if I say I is 1, then j will become what? J less than means j less than is what here? For example, n element, n is 5. So 5 minus 1 minus 1. So j is less than 3. So it will be like this. So why we are saying 3? Because the last two elements were ignored in that way. So to ignore them, we are doing like this. Okay. In selection sort, we took here I plus 1. And in bubble sort, we write here I minus 1 minus I. Here we write minus I. Okay, and this is similar. A of j is greater than A of j plus 1. See here, we are writing here j and j plus 1 because adjacent ones we have to compare. Okay, so in this way we write the code. So this is how we do this program. Thank you.